It's beautiful. It's gorgeous. Oh, thank you. Thank you, Radames, for being so kind and generous. I swear, I promise you that I will make you very happy. Very happy. I'm sorry for lying to you, but I need to save my daughter and my family, even though nobody will ever know.
Inmenso como el agua del mar, inmenso como el cielo.
How is my daughter? Where is she? Did she ever give birth to her baby? Only God knows what happened. I wonder
what... Don't think about that, Mama.
Oh, dear Lord. Oh, my dear. Oh.
The baby was born dead, Mama.
My sweetheart. Where have you been? What on earth happened to my sweet grandchild?
I can't stay very long, Mama. I have to leave. I told you already my baby was stillborn. Don't ask, Mama. Maybe I will never, ever come back. Maybe this is the last time we'll ever see each other again. I don't want you to look for me. Don't you ever try to look for me. Do you understand?
Rosalinda, please explain what's going on.
I'm trying my best to protect both my life, Mama, and your life. As far as everybody's concerned, Rosalinda Vargas Villafañe died giving birth. That's how it should be. There's a terribly dangerous woman, Mama. A nightmare in Hector's family. Orquídea Arevalo. That woman is a manifestation of the devil. And she will never cease until she destroys me. And anyone who has anything to do with me. Do you understand me now, Mama?
Rosalinda, what about the boys? What do I tell the boys?
You just tell them that Rosalinda will always be there looking after them. Tell them that they will hear from me. I will never abandon them. By the way, Mama... This is for you. Use it to buy food and also to register Aurelio Angelio in school. Whenever I can, I'll send you more money.
Rosalinda! You can't! You can't ask your own mother to believe you're dead, dear!
The baby's last names are Cordoba Vargas, like his father's and mine. Why? Hermoso!
Rosie, Hermosa is my mother's maiden name.
And?
The change is for your daughter's safety, and for your own safety.
Vladimir, if the baby loses her last name, Cordoba, she will also lose all the rights she has, everything that her father left her.
I have a plan. I'm going to the registry. We will register her with her real name and last name. Maria de Los Angeles, Cordoba Vargas. Listen, Rosalinda. We need to do everything that is possible to leave no trace of her existence. She'll be known as Maria de Los Angeles.
My beloved Hector, Radames is a good man. Affectionate. The closest I've ever been to happiness. He doesn't know anything about my past, about you, about our daughter. This is something I have kept secret forever. This is the only way I have to protect our daughter, Maria de Los Angeles. If you could only see her, she's beautiful and in good hands. The sisters at the convent are taking care of her. As soon as I can, I'm going to get her. But for now, the most important thing is to take care of my new home and prepare for revenge. The revenge with which I will destroy Orquídea Cordova Escalante. She will live to regret the day she ever crossed Rosalinda Vargas. Delicious.
Listen carefully, Pedro. Special bottles for this. Far too divine for ordinary ones. A new presentation. And make this a select special edition. Talk with Bernardo. He'll explain to you what to do. Puccini. Bravo, bravo, Puccini. Cheers to you and to your opera Turandot. And also cheers to your voice. You sing like an angel.
Please excuse me, madam. You asked me to tell you when the new herd of pregnant cattle were ready for inspection. I'm here to tell you the herd is ready now.
Did the veterinarian arrive?
No, he hasn't.
Finally getting ahead. It's been tough, but we're moving.
And growing.
Growing?
The Lord heard my prayers. He has sent us a gift from heaven. Thank God. Something I wanted so very much.
Rosalinda, are you telling me that you're pregnant?
Yes, we're going to have our first baby. I don't know if it will be a boy or it will be a girl, but a child is for sure. I'm 1 month pregnant.
When is the estimated time of the birth?
Well, boss, those two in 8 months. This one in 2 months. That one over there in 15 days. And this one tonight.
I want to be told about tonight's delivery.
Yes, ma'am.
I don't know what's going on lately.
Orquídea.
What is it?
Two or 3 years, the threats upon your daughter's life will definitely still be there. Marie de Los Angeles is the legitimate heiress of Hector Cordoba Escalante. And Orquídea knows that very well. She will not allow her to have any rights to that inheritance. At this time, the farm and the rum factory is worth a lot of money. Orquídea is very competent in business, and I'm very sure she will make the fortune grow. You'd better believe me, Rosalinda. She will never, never allow that money to go to you or anyone related to you.
Are you trying to tell me that she will try to kill my daughter?
Listen. That is a question that I'd rather not answer. Arcadia is my wife. But for now, I think that the very best thing is to have Maria de Los Angeles to stay here for a very long time. And when the time comes, we will find a way to get her out of the country.
No. You're asking me to leave my daughter. To leave my daughter here forever or for a very long time.
Rosalinda, you can come and see your daughter whenever you like. Everything must be done with great prudence.
But that's very hard for her, and very hard for me. Too much pain, too much suffering. I don't know if I can.
Listen to me. Rosalinda, you listen carefully. Your daughter, Maria de Los Angeles, she is going to live.
Of course she will.
Yes. When Maria de Los Angeles becomes a woman, she will be a very rich heiress. Until that time, we have to protect her in order for her to come and claim her legitimate right. We cannot let your motherly love put her in danger of death.
Of course not, you are right. All right. It will be as you all say.
Someone took my daughter. Someone took Andrea.
Okay.
Someone took her!
Wait for me. Okay, wait!
You scum, where are you? You give me back my daughter now! Give her back to me!
So now you see. You see what it is like to have a child in much danger of death. That is what the dirty old man did to me, Teofilo Cordoba. He took my only son. That's why I had to give you away to Vladimir Arivalo. I explained it to you, but you didn't understand. That's why I wanted you to experience what I experienced. I wanted you to feel it deep in your own bones. I wanted you to feel all the torture and the terror that I've experienced as a father.
Do you have my baby? Do you have Andrea? Please tell me, Radames, tell me.
Andrea's alive. And she's well. I'm not like you.
And how am I like?
You have the heart of the devil.
Mm-hmm.
Benito! Benito! You can bring her in.
My little sweetheart, I don't know what I'd do if anything happened to you. I adore you. Stay close now. You are your mother's only reason for living. Oh, thank you. Thank you. Thank you, Radames. Thank you. Thank you, Radames.
I already told you that I'm not like you. I only wanted you to suffer it. I wanted to teach you a good lesson. But don't make a mistake, because from now on, I swear, I will only feel hate and revenge, because that's what you planted in me. That is the gift you gave me.
Yes. Maybe you will feel some hate and revenge. But you will also feel much love. Because we've known each other since childhood. I know my kisses will never be forgotten. Never. Goodbye. Goodbye.
Wait there. This is not goodbye. Never goodbye. Because you will see me. Every day for the rest of your life. Until your last day. Remember, that's what you said to me. When you ordered my hand cut off. You told me you never wanted me to forget you. And that's what I will do. I will never forget you. Never.
Everything's all right now, baby. Everything's all right.
Okay, okay, here it is. There's enough for everybody. It's yours. Here you are. It's yours. It's yours.
Hey, come here.
Take it.
Now, give me this crate.
Not
okay.
Not
to clean the fish.
You take that away.
Now, go on. Go on, go quickly.
Here we are. Hey,
hey,
go on.
Get careful.
Go on, my dear.
Hey, come on, move me, please. Over there.
Come on, you and that thing.
There's nothing else I can do. What can I do? I know. You know how to turn this thing. Thanks.
Okay.
Okay.
That's good.
Now, thanks a lot. Let me have that bucket, will you?
So, here's your fish, my friend. Here, take your fish.
That's great. Now, give me the bucket, yeah?
Here's the bucket.
Thanks.
Listen to me, Adan. I came here especially to hear the story about how you lost your rear end. I want the complete and total story. I don't want you to admit even one detail.
Well, I used to earn my living by going underwater diving.
Uh-huh.
I would first of all tempt the animal and lift it out of the rocks without hurting its skin. In those days, we used to be paid really excellent money. You'd be surprised. But then one day, my luck turned, and one of those snakes got out of the wrong side of his bed. And didn't buy the trick of me scratching his belly and wriggled over and attacked me.
Oh, really?
His teeth went all over me. Believe me, it was really painful. I'm lucky to be alive. Very lucky. Someone took me out and saved my life. But you see, this is how it all ended up. Absolutely no rear end for me.
Ooh. Take him away.
It's not enough. I want more.
know this is very painful to you as a mother. But I'm in a position to give our sons things you cannot.
You going to raise him yourself?
No. My best friend, Giacomo Palermo. He's going to take good care of him. He is a good man. You know that's true. Also, he's the boy's godfather. So later, when I have a new home and some money, I will send for him.
I'll be seeing you, Adan.
Goodbye, Giacomo. Now I have to console Francesca. What kind of comfort can I give her when they've taken away a piece of herself? What comfort can a mother have when she has to give up her only son? Even if it's for his own good, it's tormenting. Poor Francesca, how will she survive the pain? I must try and comfort her.
Oh, Lord, how much more of this treatment do I have to put up with? How much more? How much more?
Ladies and gentlemen, whoever lasts 1 minute in this ring against Mr. America! will win! Will win a minimum of 30,000 believers! Come on! Who's willing to do it? Who's willing to step up here? Who will fight the undefeated Mr. America?
Thank you, thank you. Thanks.
Mr. Davis, where are you going?
I am going to the mayor's office to put a final and glorious end to our glorious campaign by winning.
Yeah! Yes. Thank you for you!
Thank you very much. Thank you for your support. Tomorrow, there will be a new and fairer mayor in Punta Lana. Yes.
Yes, you said it! Good for you!
And I tell you, I will be that mayor. Because I can count on my people's votes and my people's support.
Yay.
Yes. Yay. Thank you. Yay. Thank you very much. I hope I can rely on you. Yes. Thank you. Thank you.
Radames.
Thank you very much. Thank you.
Yeah,
that's great.
Radames Bezentis is the man. I tell you, he will not lose.
Hey, watch what you say there. Vladimir Arevalo has his followers as well.
No, you got it wrong. The one who's going to rule here is his wife.
Don't believe me. You fool.
Orquídea Cordoba Escalante is the one who's going to rule.
It's for your own good, Mr. Vladimir.
No!
Dan, come again. Stupid fool should be on his way to City Hall, and just look at his condition.
I don't want to be mayor of this town or of any town.
You're going to do exactly what I say. Now you drink this coffee down right away. It's very strong.
No.
Drink it.
No. Strong coffee makes me vomit all over the darn place.
But it's for your own good, Mr. Vladimir. You need to sober up in time for the election.
I don't want to. I don't want to. Besides, I'm not going to win this stupid election. Radames Bassata. He is going to win. Since he arrived in town 2 years ago. He's been working for that. He wants to be mayor of this trash of a town. He wants people who will follow him and want him.
But you know that's no problem, boss. You have all your people, too.
Of course you do. I've had half the town paid off already. There are 20 buses full of farmers who are ready and willing to go and vote for you.
You want me to be mayor of this town, don't you? Because you want to own it all. The whole thing. You want to own this town.
Thank you.
Hey, candidate.
Very much. Thank you.
Candidate, I advise you to keep far away from this ring if you want to enjoy your triumph for that injury.
Hey! Yeah!
Save your life, Mr. Radamas Pesanta. Mr. America has killed more than a few men with only his left hand.
Whoa!
But, now I don't let him use his left hand because I don't like to see blood spilled all over the ring. Come on, ladies and gentlemen, make your bets.
I'm sure Mr. Radamas can floor that clown. Why don't you go up there and teach him a lesson, Mr. Radamas? Show him! Teach him a lesson!
Now, are you crazy? Don't you know Mr. Radamas is the future mayor of this town? How can you go up there to fight that clown? It is not done. You must be out of your mind.
Silence, everybody! Silence! As for me, I believe the candidate is running scared!
Listen, friend. Mr. Radamas Pesanta is not scared of anyone or anything.
Drink your coffee, Mr. Vladimir.
I don't want any of this trash! I don't want any of this trash, I told you! Don't you listen? I don't want this trash!
For God's sake, get him sober. For God's sake, get him sober right now! If this man lying here doesn't win the election, then Radamas Pesanta will win it, and I can't ever allow that, Bernardo. I can never allow that.
Come on, fight him! Go up there! Go on!
Have a try.
One moment. My friend, you have to forgive me, but Mr. Radamas Pesanta is going to be the mayor of this town, and he can't go up to the ring to fight a clown in front of a crowd.
So if he's a clown, why is Mr. Radamas scared then?
I already told you. Mr. Radamas Pesanta is not afraid of anybody or anything.
Well, well, well. Since Radamas is missing one hand, I don't think he can do it. I think he'll lose.
You think so? Let's see if it's true.
Greetings, Mr. Radamas. Best of luck to you.
You be very careful. Maybe this clown is really good, and he knocks you down and makes you look like a fool in front of the voters. It could be real bad for you.
Benito, I'm missing one hand, not two. Just watch me.
Pesanta. I know it is. Isn't he the one you said was your father? Yes. You're gonna knock out your own father.
And the award of goodwill goes to Miss Carrie Josefina Urbina Tobal.
Rubber band. Yes, here it is. In my pocket. I can't wait. Here, try this one. Wow, this one's big enough to stun an elephant.
Shh. Quick, it ain't good. Don't miss.
Oh,
Rodrigo is out there, and he's dying to meet you.
Is he cute?
You'll find out.
The last award for today is a combination of two special awards for this institution. These two awards are for the best in religious education and for the best in good citizenship.
The rubber band?
Rubber band's ready. I just need a weapon.
Here. Hey, but this looks like a clip.
Yes, but a very special clip.
And the winner for this award, for the very best in religious education and best citizenship, is Mabel Colbajo.
Come to think of it, this clip could be the most perfect weapon yet.
Prepare yourself.
Whenever you're ready to give the order, my commandant.
Now do it! Who the hell did that? Mabel.
The award will be temporarily suspended for Mabel Colbajo. Please step down. The ceremony is over. On behalf of the sisters, we invite you to join us for refreshments in the courtyard.
Andrea.
Hello.
How are you?
The ceremony was very nice, right?
Nice. I would say it was very funny. I bet that they won't be able to sit down for a long time.
Did you see everything?
Everything. And I can tell you those were not bees that stung those girls. I guarantee that for sure.
Sir, you're very observant.
Oh, please don't be so formal. You make me feel so old.
Where are my manners? I haven't introduced you two. This is Maria de Los Angeles, my brother Rodrigo.
A pleasure.
Nice to meet you. I'll see you later.
Sure.
Excuse me.
Brother.
Oh, what a woman, Andrea. She's incredibly gorgeous.
Yes, and she's not only gorgeous, but a lot smarter than you think.
So why didn't you introduce me to her before?
Firstly, she never seems to go out. Plus, in love, you know you're a lot more dangerous than an Indian hunter.
Hey, Radames is beating the hell out of him.
Hey, Mr. America. You're meant to be even tougher than a pig's behind. Come on, let's see you put on a show. Mr. America, get prepared. You're about to go down.
My vote. Let's make him mayor.
Yeah! Now I'm going to unveil him. Oh my God, I know you. I've seen you somewhere before.
Now we can have a little chat. About those strange insects that were attacking the girls receiving awards at the ceremony earlier.
Sister Martha, here.
Thank you.
You're welcome. I've told you we should exterminate. We have so many strange bugs.
Oh, dear Maria, I know you better than anyone. You're an expert with a slingshot. You can hit a target a mile away.
Sister Teresa, who is my mother?
I told you we would talk about that later. By the way, Maria de Los Angeles, who in your opinion is going to win the election?
They all say that Mr. Radames Bassandra is an excellent candidate, But from what I know, he's been out of town for over 20 years. But see, I want to talk to you about my mother today.
Vladimir Arevalo will win the election. He's a good man. And not only that, he was born in this town.
You can't get away from me anymore. Sister, we're talking about my mother today. I can't wait one more day. It has to be today.
I do know you, right?
I've never seen you before in my life.
Are you sure?
Completely sure.
I have a picture of my son who looks a lot like you when he was 13 years old. I haven't heard from him in a long time. You didn't have to let me win. So do you think I'm some sort of fool? Do you think that I couldn't tell what you were up to? Even so, I would have won with only one hand.
The prize! The prize! Give Radamus's prize of 30,000 bolivars! He's earned it!
Yes, and give him the champion's belt as well.
The 30,000 will go to the town's emergency center. It'll be my pleasure to donate it. It will be used to buy all that's necessary, or at least it will be spent on as much as the money will buy. Alcohol injections. Band-aids. Lots of bandages. And as far as the belt goes, I want the champion's belt to be hung around the stupid idiot's neck. Who let me beat him? Who threw himself on the mat? But don't you worry, he would be no danger to me. Because he's no match for Radames Basanta.
I've been looking for you for a very long time, and you keep getting away from me.
I have been very busy.
But now you can answer me, Sister Teresa. And you're going to tell me who my mother is right now.
Is that an order?
I'm begging. My dreams. My hopes. My mother's name and her face. Her skin. I have so many questions.
And I don't have answers. I don't even know your mother's name. Maria de Los Angeles.
Then I'm leaving here right now. I need to find out the answer somewhere.
And this is how you will repay to us all the love we've given you here?
I don't believe that. You don't know my mother's name.
If you don't really trust me, you will never be able to trust anyone. There's nobody in the whole wide world who loves you like I do.
Well, if you love me so much, sister, please take this pain away and tell me the truth about where I come from.
Your mother comes to see you once in a while. She sees you from afar. She always asks and wants to know how you are doing. She suffers and cries for you, Maria de Los Angeles. I've seen her crying.
Why hasn't she ever spoken to me? Why hasn't she come nearer to me if she's been close by the convent?
I hear you. But there are mysteries in your family no one has ever told me. All they told me was to love you, to take care of you, to watch over you, as if you were a real daughter to me. And we've all done our best in that. Especially Sister Margarita and I. Now it is really up to your blood family to explain what I do not know.
Well, I'm of legal age now. Over 20 long years of being patient is more than enough. You told me it was possible that my mother would come tomorrow. Well, I want to see her. Face to face. Without any excuses. Sister Teresa, If you're unable to tell me the truth about myself, I will go out and find it. Delicious. Listen carefully, Pedro. Special bottles for this. Far too divine for ordinary ones. A new presentation. And make this a select special edition. Talk with Bernardo. He'll explain to you what to do. Bravo, Puccini. Bravo, bravo, Puccini. Cheers to you and to your opera Turandot. And also cheers to your voice. You sing like an angel. Thank you, Radames, for being so kind and generous. I swear, I promise you that I will make you very happy. Very happy. I'm sorry for lying to you, but I need to save my daughter and my family, even though nobody will ever know.
Inmenso, inmenso como el agua del mar, inmenso como un cielo.
How is my daughter? Where is she? Did she ever give birth to her baby? Only God knows what happened. I wonder
what... Don't think about that, Mama.
Oh, dear Lord. Oh, my dear. Oh.
The baby was born dead, Mama.
My sweetheart. Where have you been? What on earth happened to my sweet grandchild?
I can't stay very long, Mama. I have to leave. I told you already my baby was stillborn. Don't ask, Mama. Maybe I will never, ever come back. Maybe this is the last time we'll ever see each other again. I don't want you to look for me. Don't you ever try to look for me. Do you understand?
Rosalinda, please explain what's going on.
I'm trying my best to protect both my life, Mama, and your life. As far as everybody's concerned, Rosalinda Vargas Villafañe died giving birth. That's how it should be. There's a terribly dangerous woman, Mama. A nightmare in Hector's family. Orquídea Arévalo. That woman is a manifestation of the devil. and she will never cease until she destroys me and anyone who has anything to do with me. Do you understand me now, Mama?
Rosalinda, what about the boys? What do I tell the boys?
You just tell them that Rosalinda will always be there looking after them. Tell them that they will hear from me. I will never abandon them. By the way, Mama, this is for you. Use it to buy food and also to register Aurelio and Aurelio in school. Whenever I can, I'll send you more money.
Rosalinda! You can't. You can't ask your own mother to believe you're dead, dear.
The baby's last names are Cordoba Vargas, like his father's and mine. Why? Hermoso.
Rosie, Hermosa is my mother's maiden name.
And?
The change is for your daughter's safety and for your own safety.
Vladimir, if the baby loses her last name, Cordoba, she will also lose all the rights she has, everything that her father left her.
I have a plan. I'm going to the registry. We will register her with her real name and last name. Maria de Los Angeles Cordoba Vargas. Listen, Rosalinda. We need to do everything that is possible to leave no trace of her existence. She'll be known as Maria de Los Angeles.
My beloved Hector, Radames is a good man. Affectionate. The closest I've ever been to happiness. He doesn't know anything about my past, about you, about our daughter. This is something I have kept secret forever. This is the only way I have to protect our daughter, Maria de Los Angeles. If you could only see her, she's beautiful and in good hands. The sisters at the convent are taking care of her. As soon as I can, I'm going to get her. But for now, the most important thing is to take care of my new home and prepare for revenge. The revenge with which I will destroy Orquídea Cordova Escalante. She will live to regret the day she ever crossed Rosalinda Vargas.